This boy should be in school. In fact, he is. He's 17 years old and goes to a Soweto high school. But today he's taken the day off to take stock of his business, trading in mandrakes and dafa inside the school ground, for which he has to carry a gun.
It's like when I'm in school, me, Kanjan, already. I'm not scared. Because when I'm not carrying a gun, I will die.
This is Inanda, a township south of Durban. It's notorious for violence and gangsterism. Gun-Free South Africa is a non-government organization. They campaign to rid township schools of guns. A primary school one would think would not need such a talk. Just a week ago, teachers here found pupils carrying knives. Some have only ever seen guns in movies, but for many, they are no laughing matter. Many children bring flowers and toys to show and tell with teacher, but these children choose to speak of horror. Inanda streets are rough. So rough that not only children but adults run scared. One of the teachers has witnessed several crimes inside the school gates. Now he comes to school with a gun.
Even the primary school is not safe because even high school kids and outsiders can come in and hijack us and cause problems for us within the school. Even the fact that it's a primary school is here now is neither here nor there. If somebody can assure me that I'm safe within the school without my gun, obviously I'll have to go along with that. But as it is, no ways. I'll have to carry a gun.
Here, no threat is taken lightly. The boy who spoke of the shooting at assembly was threatened when he returned to class. The schoolmate said they would give his name to the shooter and tell him to get him. The thought of a gun can strike fear into the heart of a grown man, even more so for a 10-year-old. The boy comes back to class only after his classmates have promised not to reveal his identity. This is the scene of a fatal shooting at a high school. One pupil gunned down another. As in most cases of school violence, this one was also in a township school. Violence in the playground is a fact of life in townships.
A 17-year-old suspect has been apprehended after shooting dead a fellow pupil at a school northeast of Pretoria.
This was the scene of a pupil-on-pupil shooting earlier this year at a private school in Pretoria. It's made news, big news. Yet violence in many township schools, including shootings, feature less prominently in the media. Some say it's because they happen so often. The word township is common in most incidents, from stabbings to shootings, to beating of teachers. A life riddled with gangsterism beyond the school gate is another factor. This school got some media attention earlier this year. A damp, urine-soaked corridor. It was here that the fate of a 17-year-old pupil was decided. Details remain sketchy, but another pupil was apparently fooling around with a gun. A shot was fired, hitting Nkosikhona Ngema in the back. Since Goskona's death, parents have hired a private security guard for the school, trying to make it safer.
We believe that the school will be safe when we got a security. When we don't have the security, then the school won't be safe.
Another township, the same problems outside the school gates. Brian Ramadillo works for the Education Rights Project. They hold workshops with local communities to make them aware of their legal rights when getting their children educated. One such right is learning, free from fear and intimidation.
But I think I should just tell you.
But getting this enforced is no easy task. And whose job is it to keep the teachers and pupils safe?
I think most of them are quite correct, actually. But the first thing is that it is true indeed that
the problems these youngsters face in getting an education are a far cry from the safety of suburban schools.
The problem is the locations within which the schools are, which are themselves very, very violent. You know, so I think you can't deal the problem of violence in schools without also dealing with the immediate surroundings of the school. When you look at schools that are located in relatively wealthy areas, they don't have such huge problems. I mean, they do have problems of indiscipline that is widespread, and they're few, and they can be dealt with quite easily at the level of government bodies and so on. You know? But I think schools that are located in very poor areas and under-resourced, you know, the problem of violence that is endemic in the community comes into the school.
This is not a weekend. It's barely midday in the middle of a school week. Every Wednesday and Friday, all Soweto schools shut at noon for so-called sports day. Some do indeed play sport. Others loiter around, a short invitation, some say, to climb. 2 weeks ago, vandals burned down a classroom at this school.
If the department were to think of a steel palisade fence, I think that one would be strong enough to last. Because I think our biggest problem is people easily come into the school because there are holes all over the shore.
Yeah, like what?
Sometimes the menace is inside the school gates. Here, pupils are discovered with weapons. They are there to use on each other or to enforce illegal deals inside the school gates.
If the weather is not cold, how is the weather? Right?
Some drug dealers are pupils themselves.
Yeah, I sell drugs in school, you see. Yeah, because one man you will see my one. All right, the man and the two in the laser right to one. In the end, I would imagine it's really mal. You would imagine it's pande, let me pay see drugs, let me pay sell the man. It's what I went to me show. All right, the man is a vessel, it's a tool, no man, you know, get this girl, it's in a soap, me, that's what I want. Yeah, we imagine which we told him, I mean, we end the length of the end of those pande, let's all. Which you won't joke, I want. But man is just so far. All right, me as well, we'll go to freedom, freedom. If you don't know how to see as a teen, I want. Mobazan is cool listening into Skyrail, which will write into so, and so wrong, I want. School and you see rough. I want a school and you see cool is a money, up to the money pay some drugs. Uniforms, it's an orange.
Then there are times the pupils turn on the teachers. At this school 4 weeks ago, pupils beat a group of teachers unconscious. They accuse them of having affairs with schoolgirls. All these are government schools. Anyone trying to stem the tide of violence must negotiate with the education department first. This can take time. In the meantime, the violence continues.
Yes, good afternoon. Take a seat. Thank you.
Nobody at the Department of Education is coming up to say, I can work with gun-free South Africa. That is my frustration. You speak to this person, you are referred to, he says, no, go to so-and-so, go to so-and-so. Now she says we are restructuring, and it feels to me that we are starting a new page with him, a very, very clean page with the Department of Education.
This is Ganyamazan in Mpumalanga, a province whose schools have made many headlines recently. And it's not always the pupils who get out of hand. Kenneth Mpofu would know. Kenneth was tortured by his own teacher, who accused him of stealing from her handbag. It's an isolated case. Yet there are fears that other teachers in the province could crack when working with unruly, dangerous pupils. They could be tempted down the same path. Kenneth carries lifelong scars. He's also infertile from the blows to his genitals. The offending teacher had to pay a fine. Her union feels she should not have lost her job.
Even if a person is discharged from work, but we should be able to put a mechanism in place so that when he's given the second chance to come back to the system, you know that you are talking about a clean person. I mean, I'll give you an example. How do you then begin to agree that we need to rehabilitate drug addicts and put them back into the community and not rehabilitate people who torture other people?
But you do agree that by virtue of her conduct, she is not fit and proper to be a teacher. Do you or don't you agree?
Yes, we agreed that the conducts are not acceptable in the teaching fraternity. But we do agree that that particular person can then be rehabilitated and be back into the system, especially that she has been teaching for the past 20 years and she only committed to one mistake of torturing. Therefore, to us, we are saying that she has not repeated the same thing for the second time. Therefore, she needed to be given a particular chance.
Schools under siege. That's how Mpumalanga schools were recently described. It's barely 9 a.m. The police are already here to arrest a trespassing former pupil. He'd earlier in the year wreaked havoc at the school, sparking weeks of riots. The offending pupils accuse the principal of witchcraft.
Calm down. This is the second time. It's that last year we had this problem where learners, they attended the show and they had some accidents and one of them died. Then they started throwing stones at the school saying they are being bewitched by the teachers. And they made some writings on the walls which were removed by the MEC. Saying they are being bewitched by the teachers who want to be strong.
Sounds almost funny, but not if you're a teacher facing a mob of stone-throwing pupils out to hurt you.
It's just like what is happening with the rural areas in KwaZulu-Natal. People move from our area here to those areas. So that's exactly.
Last year, a learner threatened a teacher in the village with a gun. So we tried to talk this to the father, communicated this to the father. You know, all his parents will play safe to say, I didn't know this. Well, we will try and solve the problem. It is very tough to be a teacher in this area.
Later the same day, Special Assignment visited a nearby primary school. There we find the familiar blue and white of the police van. Just minutes earlier, two gunmen had walked in, held up and then robbed the teacher, then simply walked out. According to Satu, it wasn't the first time.
This course has got stick. It's not an armament of some kind, and it's useless in terms of to defend himself against people that are wielding guns at the level of the schools.
All the teachers at the school are women. This, they say, makes them easy targets for thugs to rob or attack them. They not only fear those who ambush them outside when they leave, some are brazen enough to walk right through the gate.
After that,
Teachers say they love being here. Many have spent their entire working years at this school, but they are tired of teaching in fear. The department recently rejected suggestions that teachers arm themselves in this province or any province. Give us alternatives then, the teachers say.
Ngaso sonke isikhathi kusekuseni kusemini noma kuhamba masipholakala singakaphephi. Singajabula ama-government angasenza thathe kunyathelo letinyenyana asipholele ama-security langcono langasive nathi siphephile ngoba akusimnazi usuke ekhaya wati kahle ukuthi lawo yakhona ukaphephi ngentela noma yini ngawo.
Petrus Dumisa is a principal in Mpumalanga. The school is set in a scenic spot overlooking the nearby Kruger Park. His baptism of fire came before he could even notice the view on his very first day.
I heard noise outside, and thereafter it was followed by a gunfire. And I did not know what to do at that point in time. And scared as I was on my first day, I really moved together with the other teachers that were available, and stones were just raining. And then we moved into this office. We locked ourselves in, and there is a small window outside, and more stones were being thrown from that side, and then we just went under the table and tried to cover our heads and use chairs, you know, to protect ourselves, to make sure that those stones which were coming through the windows should not necessarily hit us.
The pupils were angry that they had not been consulted on who the new principal would be. The community said he had not introduced himself to the chief.
My regional directors, together with the other people from the Department of Education in Mpumalanga, they became very much instrumental in making sure that there is a common understanding, bringing the chief on board also. And then I was taken to the chief. I was introduced to the chief. And that was resolved.
SATU says its members can't teach when their lives are in danger. It says the government has ignored its calls for proper security. They feel that slogans like gun-free zones are little more than lip service.
We were advocating for schools to be areas of free gun zones. But at the same time, when you look at the safety and security of those educators, because next time they're going to be shot, as I indicated, there's one incident where a principal has been shot at close range. Therefore, if you cannot protect yourself, who's going to protect you?
There are some possible solutions, like stationing police at schools. For many schools, this would be a luxury, but essential. If you are to stamp out the growing anarchy,
you can't only deal with it only as an educational issue, you know, and it's not only as an issue of resources in education only, but also as an issue of resources in the communities. For example, in some of the communities where there's huge problems of violence in schools, the police stations are not operational. There's no vehicles. There's not enough staff.
The user image of schools appears not far off the mark. But then again, so is the reality of the life beyond these school gates.
The country of South Africa is not only wanting to work with schools, but also with the communities around the schools, so that the schools don't feel uncomfortable that they are standing there saying, you know, firearms. Yet the community is wanting to attack them.
These schools need to become places of safety and of learning once again. Until then, there will always be someone ready to take the gap.
Why don't you go get a job then?
Where?
When you finish school.
Finish school, yep. And if you put on your hand, you might just get a little bit of up. If you have a crease, a crease or a so-called, I think seven is lovely. You know what I'm sure of. I'm going to go to my university. 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 I'm going